In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet angle pair relationships, and I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. So the first part of this worksheet, we're going to name the relationship. We're either going to name it complementary, linear pair, vertical, or adjacent. Complementary angles, the sum of the angles equals 90 degrees. That's complementary. For adjacent angles, they have a common vertex, a common side, and they do not share interior points. So they have a common vertex and a common side. Vertical angles are two angles that are formed by intersecting lines, but they are not adjacent. And finally, we'll go over linear pair. So linear pair are two adjacent angles that are formed by opposite rays, where the opposite rays are the non-common sides. So let's go over each of the definitions one more time, and I'll leave a link in the description below so that you can access my tutorial where I go more in depth with each definition and I also give diagrams. So complementary, the sum of the angles will equal 90 degrees. Adjacent angles, they share a common vertex and they share a common side. For linear pair, we have two adjacent angles that are formed by opposite rays. So opposite rays come out of the same endpoint and go opposite directions. So essentially a straight line. However, for a linear pair, those opposite rays aren't the common side of the adjacent angles. And finally, vertical angles are formed by intersecting lines, but are not adjacent angles. So knowing those definitions, let's look at number one. For number one, we can tell right away that these are definitely adjacent angles, since they share a common vertex and a common side. However, there is a better description of these two angles. If you notice, they're two adjacent angles, and the non-common side are two rays that are opposite each other. So this fits the definition of linear pair. So number one is a linear pair. Moving on to number two, we can see right away that angles A and B share a common vertex and they also have a common side. However, the non-common sides are not opposite rays, and A and B also do not equal 90 degrees, so this is just adjacent angles. And number three, again, A and B share a common vertex and a common side. The non-common sides are not opposite rays, so they're not going to make a straight line, and this does not total to give us a right angle. Therefore, A and B are just adjacent angles. In number four, you can see that A and B share a common vertex and a common side, so we know they are definitely adjacent angles. However, there's an important symbol that we have here. That shows that the angle adjacent B is a right angle, so that is equal to 90 degrees. And since this is a straight line, and we know that a straight line totals to be 180, that means this angle right here also has to be 90 degrees. So A and B are complementary because angle A plus angle B equals 90 degrees. So for number four, our answer is complementary. And number five, notice that A and B share a common vertex. However, they do not have a common side. So these are not adjacent angles. There's also no indication that they could potentially be 90 degrees, so they're not complementary. And since they do not have a common side, we know that, therefore, it's also not a linear pair. However, there's a definition that we haven't used yet, and that is vertical angles. So let's go back up to our definitions. Vertical angles are formed by intersecting lines, but they are not adjacent. And that is exactly what we have in number five. A and B are formed by intersecting lines. they're intersecting at that vertex. However, they are not adjacent. Therefore, they are vertical angles. Moving on to number 6, we have angle A and angle B. They share a common side and a common vertex. However, there's no indication that they could potentially equal 90 degrees and are not opposite rays. Therefore, for number 6, we just have adjacent angles. In number 7, here is our angle A, there's our angle B. They share a common vertex and a common side, and if you look, the non-common sides are indeed opposite rays since they branch from the same endpoint going opposite directions, essentially forming a straight line. Therefore, we know that A and B are a linear pair. And the last problem in this section, number 8. We're looking at angle A and angle B. They share a common vertex, but they do not share common sides. However, this line and this line intersect to form both A and B, and since A and B are not adjacent, but they're formed by intersecting lines, then they are vertical angles. Let's move on to number 9. In this section, for numbers 9 through 18, we're finding the measure of angle B. However, we're going to use the previous definitions, adjacent angles, linear pair, vertical angles, and complementary angles to figure out the measure of this angle. So in number 9, angle B and 50 degrees together form a linear pair since they share a common vertex, a common side, and their non-common sides are opposite rays. So since they are a linear pair, and we know that opposite rays equal 180 degrees, then we can say that B plus 50 degrees equals 180 degrees, since 50 degrees plus the measure of angle B has to equal 180. All we have to do is subtract 50 degrees from both sides of our equation. So essentially, we're just subtracting 50 from 180 to get that angle B is equal to 130 degrees. In number 10, you can recognize that angle B and 43 degrees are vertical angles. And since vertical angles are formed by intersecting lines, essentially this 43 degrees is going to be reflected onto B and vice versa. So B is going to be equal to 43 degrees. Vertical angles are always equal in measure. So B is equal to 43 degrees. Number 11, B shares a common vertex and common side with 96 degrees, so it is an adjacent angle. However, we know that a full circle is 360 degrees. So 209 plus 96 plus B must equal 360 degrees. So let's add 209 to 96. So I have B plus 305 degrees, and that's going to be equal to 360 degrees. Now we just need to subtract 305 degrees from both sides of our equation. When doing that, we'll get that B is equal to 360 degrees minus 305 degrees, which is 55 degrees. And if you want to double check, plug in 55 for B, add that to 96, add it to 209, and you will get 360. Now, number 12. In number 12, they indicate that B and 63 degrees together make up a right angle, which a right angle equals 90 degrees. So B and 63 degrees are complementary. Therefore, B plus 63 degrees equals 90 degrees. So our only step is to subtract 63 degrees from that 90 degrees. We'll get that B is equal to 90 minus 63, which is 27 degrees. And in order to double check, plug 27 degrees in for B and get 27 plus 63, which is indeed 90 degrees. I'll go ahead and stop the video here. Join me in the next video, which will be the second half of this worksheet, where I'll complete numbers 13 through 22, wrapping it up. Also, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. And again, if you have any questions or comments, leave them below. And if you're confused on the definitions, go back to my tutorials, which I will link in the description.